Oh, chat. Oh, the spooks. The spooks, chat. They cometh. So, you know, before we have to deal with more Labatt Project Moon bullshit, we might as well deal with more SCP bullshit. So, welcome. Perfect. Also, we're going to do custom. We're going to make things normal. We're going to have the SCPs be aggressive as fuck, but we can save anywhere. So let's get in there. First, focus on evacuation. Oh, nice. Hasn't noticed us yet. Well, this is unfortunate now, isn't it? So much happening, chat.
Attention, all personnel report to immediately.
It's gone yet. Nope. Later, you peanut fucker. Okay, chat. Wood's gonna get the hell out of here. Okay, maybe aggressive SCPs was a bad call. But we'll have them on normal. Cause he seems real pissed. What?
Yes, I know you're alive. Yes, I was. You asked me to join. I was doing something.
We just were telling you the stream's active, but if you want to be a part of SCP.
Oh, you know what? I figured that much as well.
I mean, to be fair, we thought you were going to join for Limbus Company, so you might as well be here until that happens. Because this time we're not doing a mirror dungeon first. We're gonna jump into the main stuff. Also, you didn't see it, but aggressive SCP made Peanut real fucking mad. We couldn't go Okay, so here's the fucked up part. We opened this door and he was instantly there.
Ah, yes.
And then we went down the hall. Like, we went this way. we went... Oh, hallway's changed. Oh, we went this way. We went up. There was like a hallway here. We went up it, and he was instantly there. So we can save anywhere, but it's normal. Because we think saving anywhere is nice, because if there was a few more computer screens, maybe. But there's so few.
Oh, I forgot about the fact that someone just comes charging towards you and they randomly fall.
Yeah, no, because they get tased.
Yeah. Wait, does that mean that whoever stunned like, dazed, or was all these just
No, they're dead.
Dead.
That was enough volts to kill somebody.
What kind of volts do you need to have?
The kind of volts that's meant to stop an SCP. Actually, funny enough, you know the old man?
Yes.
If he goes through it, he doesn't die, but that's how you get rid of him. If he gets shocked by it, he fucks off for a second. So enough volts to make an immortal SCP run away.
So shit ton then.
Oh, fuckload. What's funny though is the computer is actually in control of them right now.
Oh.
So if you play SCP Secret Labs, the MMO one, the guy who's in charge of the computer, he's actually activating those. Trying to take you out. We need a key card. So right now we think everything is randomly rolled because we didn't make it black sheep. Like, actually, no, fuck that. We wanna have our own thing.
So what?
We're gonna have the map seat. We had it be black sheep.
What does black sheep do again?
Okay. So the first tabletop we did with Kane in the Academy City, we were a Black Ops team, and we got to everyone was like, oh yeah, what is the name people want for the team? We chose Black Sheep because in another tabletop we've been doing with our buddy for over 10 years, Eve, one of our characters, which is kind of basically the Golden Age Woden, she had a mercenary team called the Black Sheep because it was a team of Black Sheeps, outcasts who came together for a bigger purpose. And in the most recent session, we went to one of the founding members of the Black Sheep. We went to her school before the events of the campaign. So we thought it'd be fun of, since Woden as a map seed was dog shit. Actually, you know what? Trust, what do you think the map sheet should be? Because we didn't get very far with Black Sheep. We just did that, like, the first run. Seemed kind
of
neat.
I have one, but it's a bit of a poetic one.
Okay.
Black Paradise.
Okay, so we're going to keep Black Sheep.
Well, I found it poetic.
Yeah,
than Paradise as...
Yeah, we thought you were going to say, like, Crimson or something. We kind of... The joke of these names is we kind of want to see what random mapping gives us for names.
Oh.
Because this affects the whole facility of how it's laid out.
Wait, so what happens if we put my entire username in there?
It makes a map based off your username.
What does that look like, though?
To be fair, what does Black Sheep look like? Because this one had some options of where we could go. So we want to give this a good... God,
the Peanut is already there.
Well, yeah, no, he always spawns there. No, he's always there because there's two guys in this room, and he goes after them. There's a scientist and a guard. He's chasing them. That's why the lights go out and he doesn't kill us. Yeah, he's going after a completely different one.
I see.
Yeah, we opened it. He was right there. So we were able to bamboozle him, right? So then we went this way, because this door is already open for some unexplainable reason. Also...
Ooh.
Howdy.
There's a man on the floor!
So we went into this room. We opened this door. Peanut was already here.
Nice. Collect that card and...
So we're in the
else.
Infinite hallway.
Indeed you are. Indeed you.
What's wild is we don't think the infinite hallway is, like, dangerous. It's just infinite and annoying.
Attention. All personnel report to...
You got it, Captain. SCP-9... Wait, what?
What?
Hold on, this this is for a guy further on.
Who?
This is a different SCP we haven't seen yet in this stream. On our own time, we've seen him. Let's see, our pack-based predators, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Primitive luring place imitates human speech. Oh no, it's just talking about the dogs. Okay, never mind. Well, this is talking about the other weird fuckers. In the darkness. And naturally, they're a Keter. AKA, don't poke it. I think they'll spawn more stuff. You know what? This cup is ours. What? So, any words of wisdom for Callie's daughter in the middle of all this nonsense?
Get good, I guess.
Okay. Oh shit, that worked!
Somehow!
Okay.
How is this room? Oh, peanut boy!
Hold on.
Hi there!
Hold on. As long as you didn't come through the window, we think there's a better key card.
What do you mean, Nick?
He just came through the window.
What? What? You better close that door, too!
Come on, fucker, come here. Come on!
Doesn't he come at Mach 5, though?
Yeah, but we know the distance. Oh, he left. Oh, you cheating son of a bitch! Okay, hold on.
Ooh.
Okay, it sucks. Hold on. There's...
Peanut boy!
Oh, it's so annoying, because we should be able to see when we're about to blink.
Peanut boy!
Can you see that? No, it's just not there. What the fuck? There's supposed to be there's supposed to be a thing where you see when your character's about to blink. But it might be in the newest one, it's just you have to guess. Okay. Come on.
Well, hi the peanut. Peanut boy.
Right.
I just thought of something that's horrifying in actual life in the Project Moon universe.
That there is definitely a peanut, and the peanut should fuck off forever.
No. You know how in, like...
Aha! A level 2 key card! Thank God. Anyway, keep going.
As well, meaning, like, imagine something like the peanut as an, in something in Project Moon. Well, it only moves
baby.
When you look at it. Well, it only moves when you don't look at it.
Oh, baby.
Meaning all 12 littles have to at least keep a contact with it.
Well, that's...
And of course, it probably won't be moving at Mach 5, but
well,
it probably
well,
move at...
Well, Project Moon has something like that.
What?
Yeah, remember in Lobotomy Corp, the thing, like, the tree. If you
oh,
don't
yeah!
look at the tree, it gets pissed as fuck.
But that stabs you anywhere.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Yes, but no, it burrows through the ground and starts reaching towards the surface.
Oh yeah, it's burrowing heaven, right?
Yep. And then, of course, there's the other one we've seen in Limbus Company, which is if you do look at it, it gets mad.
Wait, remind me what that one is again?
No fucking no, it's one you see in the dungeons. But it's
Wait.
Like, it's like, oh, look at it or close your eyes, and it looks like burrowing heaven, but it's supposed to be the opposite.
Oh yeah, that thing!
But that's an actual that person. Like, that's a physical moving object, which we think is... way more interesting. An SCP
yeah.
where you're not supposed to look at it.
I imagine it looking something similar to the Weeping Angels, ironically enough.
Well, I mean, it's fully... unlike Burrowing Heaven, it's a full, like, humanoid creature.
Yeah.
The one in Limbus Company, so...
I would assume it would look like the Weeping Angels. Well, instead of dragging you somewhere else, they just grip you by the throat and just...
Also, this is some bullshit, because we don't think we can see the map, can we?
Probably not.
No, is there a map, Tress? Do you see it on the screen?
Nope.
Oh. Okay, so, what's cool, though, is if we can find the dude who can upgrade stuff, this can become an SCP finder, where it'll show us the SCPs on the map. So that's a good find. And, now that we have level T key card, we can actually go to most SCPs on this level, because we're in light containment. So level 2 should get us around the facility pretty easily. That was the problem with the...
I kind of hope they made the alterations a canon thing, to be honest. If it isn't already an existing thing.
Your mom's an existing thing.
I kind of want the Blue Shepherd to come back, you know? It seems like an interesting concept.
Okay, so the artist didn't want, like, their comic out there. But technically...
It makes me wonder, if someone else redrew it, would that count?
We don't think so. We just think, like, that artist didn't want to be associated with Project Moon because of the controversies. But technically, the monsters they made technically would still have to be canon, because two of the monsters they made were for... The Wizard of Oz. And you can't just go, no, those don't count anymore because I drew them.
That's why
the Blue Shepherd is a real fairy tale.
Yeah, so that's why I wonder if someone else would have to draw it.
We think it's more of a peanut situation where it's like, as if you use this certain version of the peanut, then they're upset. But if you redraw the statue,
which is what I'm referring to.
Fuck, can't go that way.
Which I would assume it would still, like, I assume it would still count, you know? I'm talking count as it would go through the whole thing.
Well, no, yeah, it would. That's what we're saying. It'd be fine.
Yeah. I kind of hope they would draw it like that, to be honest. I kind of want to know what the new,
we kind of hope that entire thing is canon, and they just redraw most of it and go through it again. Because we really love a lot of that series.
To be honest, same. I love the idea of it all being canon. Like all the information, all this, like, the fact they could record all of you, as in record what stats all, essentially.
Typically, that's already canon, because in Lobotomy Corp, you have to buy that information from Yosin. They already know.
Yeah, I'm talking in the comments. You know? Because the idea of
your
it is
face,
fascinating.
Got him.
Oh, okay.
We'll be taking that.
Is that the gas mask?
No. Well, that is a gas mask, but there is also an SCP gas mask. What is this? I already know about him.
The ear bears.
Wait. No, this doesn't have blue code on it. Fuck off.
Is that the ear bear?
Yep. SCP, blah, 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 accompanied by Tavery, similar shape and size, but it was made to Dark Carver was able to call out the scene, along with the security team, and refers to him to contain the SCP in his hypish shriek.
What does that say?
No, it's already said. Now that's talking about. Hold on.
It's 108, so.
Hold on.
That's the ear boy.
No. This was telling us about the ears.
Oh. Then what's the other one?
That's the one that makes it. Do we not?
Is that the one that makes
This might be a different one. Hold on. Because there's also one bear known as the Architect.
Oh, yeah, that weird-ass bear. I forgot about the weird-ass bear that makes more bears.
No, that was the other. They're talking about the other. Hold on. No. It does make the bears. So, SCP-1048-A, which is basically like a mini. So, if it has a dash A, that's something made by the machine. The Plague Doctor, his zombies would be SCP-049-A.
Yeah.
So, something. Okay. So we don't need that. But what about you? Probably seven months after using various materials. So this guy recreates himself from a bunch of shit. Lost in security. Currently, there are three known creations of SCP-148. 14B, 14C. Okay, so 148A is the ear bear, which is making more ears. But then there's two other ones. Yes.
So we got A, B, and C, I think.
And right? They all exhibit extreme fucking violence. But yes, we're not sure if the other ones are also made out of ears or turns you into ear monsters, but we know SCP-1408.
A? I
think. A seems to be doing that, yeah.
Look, A, like, I just know one bear makes it turn into a bunch of ears.
That's A.
Yes.
And this one, though, isn't hostile against humans. It's just chilling. But
oh,
it's...
Oh, that's the one that was looking through the window.
Yeah,
that
that's 1408. But 1408A, the one that shrieks, if you've noticed, that one's all red because that one's made out of human ears.
Oh, boy.
So that one hates people. All of its creations hate people, but it, meanwhile, is just kind of hanging. Chilling.
Oh, yeah.
I'm taking your wallet. Goodbye.
By most, you won't be needing this again.
Mostly because now we can put our key cards in there and other such various shit. No idea what other various shit, but we can. Do we need you? Nope.
I don't think we do.
So we want
it is. What? Ooh. Card.
Yo, we wonder what happens if we upgrade a clipboard.
I assume, I assume it would just get more information. Like, it would have more clipboard space, I assume. So what's this weird shady ass room?
We can learn lore. SCP-162 is... So technically, the lore is... People have, like, looked into it. Because our D-class is weirdly capable of dealing with all this.
Yeah,
it's implied that it's implied that us quick saving, whether you know we use the screens or whatnot, is canon. We survive because we can quick save. However, if we use this abnormality, we find out there's a traitor working for the Chaos Foundation. You remember that corpse that flew through the ceiling earlier?
Yes.
That's the traitor. But when you go to his office, it says that he framed somebody else. It's implied we're that guy. So we're a scientist, and that's why we are able to deal with all these abnormalities, but at the same time, the fact that we survived a containment breach makes us an SCP. So
yeah, that makes sense, totally.
So, one of the endings is if you don't have the Chaos Insurgency get you, then the Foundation gets you, and they're just like, yeah, we don't know how the fuck he did all this. But we're not even sure he should be a D-class anymore. He should just straight up be an SCP.
Yeah, I don't blame that either.
And then the two under endings is you nuke the facility.
Which
or you get gunned down.
Go. Wait, what? Gunned down casually.
Yep, because you... Okay, so if you help the robot dude... No, actually, if you... Yeah, if you help the robot dude... get to the internet, then he helps you unlock the Alpha Warhead nuke. Using that, the second you use it, you see that big lizard guy that's immortal break out and pimp slap a helicopter before the nuke goes off. Not that it would have stopped him, but if you don't do that and you try to leave the way the robot tells you to go, you're gunned down by Nine-Tailed Fox because he essentially sent you to your death. So basically, don't trust the robot.
Yeah.
But if you don't,
I gather this much.
And you go the other way, then the Chaos Insurgency finds you. They don't kill you. They cut off the SCP Foundation and take you with them. If that's good or bad, who can truly say? But you're now with them. Or if you go with the SCP Foundation, you're basically classified as maybe D-class, maybe an SCP. Neither are really awesome options, but at least you're not dead. And, you know, as an SCP for the Foundation, you're not being put up to test to other SCPs, for the most part. Like, there are actually SCPs in this world that are just like humans. Like, one girl has the ability to go into photos, like, reach into it and fuck with photos, even from the past. So she could stop someone's heart. Like, if she had a picture of Hitler, she'd go in there and stop his heart.
You could just yeet. Yeet.
And it's just something that happened. But she's not, like, a malicious devil or anything. She's just... She's like an X-Men. Yeah, she's just an X-Men. So, like, for there's actually a couple stories in the SCP Foundation that aren't about, like, if you there's another section in the SCP lore, which is just about stories. And, like, one of the stories is, like, she gets to wander the facility with a handler. And she's like, yeah, I want to leave. And they're like, you know why we can't let you leave. The fact that you get to walk around is already good enough. Come on now. There's one SCP that's a drawing of a woman who fucked around. And, like, you could talk with the woman, do all this. And if she went into paintings, like Picasso's paintings, she could go into those paintings and interact with that world. And then one day she learned she was a drawing and just became horribly depressed. And all the scientists were like, man, I feel bad now. Because she essentially learned she's not real.
I'm fascinated by that, to be honest. I do the same thing, essentially, in my own headspace.
Yeah, but it's like, imagine if Jove just, like, was like, yeah, you're a real person, we're talking to you through weird ways, and it just went, no, you're a painting, fuck you. If we ripped your paper, you'd die. What a shame, you're not a real person. And then everyone's like, bruh, hold on, but we weren't treating you bad. You have to understand, that's why you're fucking weird. The fact that it's like, the monster didn't get angry or try to like wipe out humanity. It's just like, it just went, I'm just gonna sit in a corner and just not give a shit anymore. Because what the fuck's the point of any of this? It's like, I don't know how you deal with an existential crisis like that. That's fucked up.
Yep. I'm pretty sure no one would know how to deal with it either.
So, that's one of the first things for the SCP, because one of the original SCP found, like, creators of the website was talking about, like, he described the Foundation as, like, it's not evil, but they're not wholly good. They do their job. Secure, contain, protect. They're not good, they're not evil. Yeah, LobCorp is a... I mean, yeah, because LobCorp had a good goal at the end, but had fucked up methods to get there. SCP Foundation contains monsters, even though some of them are good. Like, most of them are abominations of God, but some of them they actually let wander the facility. Like, the two eyeballs, like, the little eyeball slimes, they're like, yeah, they just let them wander the facility because who gives a shit? They're two eyeballs. Plus, because they can infinitely stare... One time, a guy was in the Peanut Boy's room, and the door malfunctioned. And he looked over like, that's it, I'm fucking dead. And the two eyeballs rushed in there and just started staring it down while the scientist was able to get out.
Oh, that's fascinating.
Because they knew, we have to stare at this thing to get my boy out. So, like, that, they're just like, yeah, they can just wander. Because there's also two SCPs, Cain and Abel. Cain was actually made for an SCP Black Op team. They made an...
Remember seeing Abel.
Yeah, Abel's allowed to wander the facility because Abel is from Cain and Abel. He's a cyborg dude, and everyone's like, yeah, he can hang out, he can go to the cafeteria. He's not allowed to leave the facility... But he can wander the whole facility because he's actively helping study stuff. He's checking stuff out. He's like, yeah, okay. Everyone's like, yep, he's here.
Chill, basically.
But if Cain was near Abel, he would actively try to beat the fuck out of him.
So it's like the Little Red Riding Hood mercenary.
It's Cain and Abel from the Bible.
Yeah, I got as much. Yeah,
but what's cool... Yeah, it looks kind of like that, but Cain used to be cool... They made him on a Black Ops team with the photo chick and some, like, a few others. And then one op against the Chaos Insurgency went bad, and Cain fucking lost his shit. To where anytime he leaves his coffin, they're just like, yeah, so we put him in an underground bunker underwater, to where it's designed to kill him. And if he ever breaches all of it, we flood the whole thing, drown the fucker, lower it, and then throw his ass back in the coffin. He's uncontrollable now because of what happened on that mission. But before that, it was like, yeah, he was aggressive, but he would work with people and you could, like, hang out with him.
I'm kind of fascinated by the thought of this now.
And then there's God.
The idea of letting them wander, some of them wander, is fascinating to me.
Yeah, because, again, they don't contain evil eldritch gods. They contain... Things everything. The normal public isn't ready for. Like, there's one of the SCPs is a chair.
Wait,
it's a plastic chair. It's a plastic chair that can just teleport to random locations. And they're like, yeah, we can't stop it, but it can just teleport fucking anywhere. And we're just, we, The fucker will just teleport. We can't stop it. It doesn't.
Please tell me the chair looks like the foggy chair from Animal Crossing.
No, it looks like the plastic chairs from school. Like, you know, like the blue plastic chairs. It's like, yeah, just fucking spawns.
Yeah, just the fact that teleport is funny to me.
Like, it's just like the only thing is, like, we think it actually will sometimes teleport in walls and glitch out. They're like, yeah, we have to stop that. It's not even evil. It's just like, once people see that, they're gonna start asking questions, and it has to. But there was one SCP that, like, much like the "Don't Touch Me" button, would transform into other stuff, but it was a ticket. And if you picked it up, eventually you would start seeing hellish hallucinations around you, and then a taxi would take you to hell, or take you to death, or whatever. But what? Once you touched them, you would die. One of the facility doctors, he was going to play with one of the main characters of the SCP Foundation in the earlier lore. And, like, he didn't realize the SCP turned into it until they were out to play. And he was like, I started noticing he was freaking out and sweating a lot. It was only after he got in the taxi I realized what had just happened. He was keeping his cool to not freak out in front of all the civilians, even though he knew he was about to die. That was a badass motherfucker. He's like, he was basically seeing hell, and he was just like, I'm not gonna make a fucking move. I know what's coming.
Yeah, the face death and the smile, and being fried in the smile.
There's also one doctor who, what, this one female doctor who may or may not be canon anymore, who wanted to fucking Abnormal.
Oh yeah, the weird boy.
I gotta go.
The boy's under you. Nice.
But no, there's one female doctor who just wants to fucking SCP or something.
Nice.
But she's like, she actively wants to, like, basically kill herself on an SCP because she finds it horny. And everyone's like, just don't fucking touch it. Stop it. Stop that shit. She's still.
There's DeviantArt for that.
Oh, no, there is. No, like, she's actually the cause of a lot of DeviantArt, but it's also, like, she's not just...
No, I'm joking when I say that, because I'm saying,
oh,
have
fuck.
Her look at the DeviantArt.
Oh fuck, I'm oh sure fuck, oh fuck. Trust is coming. No, she's coming.
The flesh boy, well, the old man.
The old man. Shit!
The old man is coming.
Also, there's supposed to be a sprint bar. If we can find a tasing thing, we're good.
Yep.
The old man is coming.
You're going to the funny dimension.
You know there's a part in this where you're in a World War II trench.
Really?
Yep. No idea how to get there. And there's like these hellish things above you that you stay under it, it starts killing you.
Is this the right way?
This isn't, nope. This is the wrong way. This isn't Secret Labs. It won't just insta-kill you. He has different scenarios. Go on then, you cocksucker.
This is weird.
Oh yeah, his dimension's wild. So anyway, we're dead and we don't even realize it yet.
This is fine. This is totally fine.
How do we get the hell out of here?
I don't wanna kneel.
Woden doesn't kneel for anyone, you old son of a bitch. Come on, then! You know what? Woden is late for fucking karaoke, and she'll fight the whole goddamn Dojima clan to get there.
Wait, what if there's an abnormality that looks like the old man?
So can we leave yet? Or hold on, does he actively... Oh shit, we crouched. We actually kneeled. This is the World War II thing. We gotta go. On your face, soldier! We are leaving! Because he's supposed
to. That's a giant metal bird.
Yeah, because he's from World War I or II. He's literally a World War I soldier. So now we're in World War I.
With giant metal birds.
Yeah, have you ever seen The Wall from Pink Floyd? Like,
nope.
The movie. So, at one point, one of the Nazi planes turns into a metal eagle.
Mm.
We think it's supposed to be a reference to that.
Probably.
Now, there is a bunker here. As long as we stay under before the bird comes, we should survive. If we had a med kit, this would be way easier. And now we want to play some music. You won't hear it. What's that one song from Toho we want to play? It's not Night of Nights. It's something similar. Because that one song we sent you that one time where it was like orchestral.
We might. Is it like? Isn't it like a piano version of, like, I'm trying to think of, like...
We're humming the tune.
You mean, like, Reach for the Moon, Immortal Smoke.
There we go. That might be it.
Because I remember it being Marco's theme, of all things.
The Moon Orchestral.
Because I know that's either Kaya's theme or Moko's theme.
Hold on. Rishi Immortal, the Moon Immortal. It, we feel like it wasn't named that. Hold on. No, it is. It's just we need to find the orchestral version. Ah, oh, fuck. It is that song. It's that song. Yeah. We have to hunt down the season DuckTail. What? Was there a DuckTales Moon? Whatever.
What?
Yeah, because in DuckTales you go to the moon, and there's a DuckTales. The moon theme for DuckTales, ballin' though.
I know there's also the. I'm trying to think of some other good themes. The Voyage 1969. And no, that's the actual name. What? The Voyage of 19 the Voyage 1969, as which is the stage theme. There's also I'm trying to think of some good.
Trying to think of this one
titles.
YouTuber, because we might be able to hunt down the exact version we want from the YouTuber.
There's the Hotman's Yokai Girl, which, it's chaotic, but it's fun chaotic.
There's also just blasting Red Hood.
Yeah.
The Wojin theme. There's a metal version.
I'm just listing various two things actually. Oh yeah, I actually know that.
On also. Your feet. Yes. Oh, we know because they've done a lot of stuff for Duo.
They actually done a lot of Juju songs for Metal Gear Solid.
Gotta go.
They have done nearly every character in fact. Want to know?
The Beast. Could lock our mouse, that'd be nice. On your face, soldier!
Yeah. We are leaving! So what happens is just a... what happens if they kill you from the fire?
Oh, you just die.
No, I mean, how do they kill you?
You just die. Location 06, location unknown. Hold on. I mean, we're in World War II. What if?
I think we're dying, Squirtle. I think we're dying.
Yeah, that's fine. You feel faint? That's fine.
Yep. We're digging our own grave.
It's not going down yet.
It's the greatest.
By God, the Germans have released fucking birds.
Okay, so you birds off the same field.
Get to cover, soldier!
Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good.
Oh, yes.
I'm curious what happened to put my entire username as a seed. You want to find out?
Not particularly. Where are we?
Back here. I think before we even got the wallet.
Alright, Trish. You know what? Fine.
Use either version if the Anko part or not. I'm curious in what the hell this would happen. Oh yeah, the coffee machine! I forgot about the coffee machine.
I don't have any liquid using the touchpad, a standard 12-ounce paper cup drinking cup, blah blah blah, motor oil, sulfuric acid, wiper fluid, as well as substances that are not used exist in liquid state, such as nitrogen.
What about shit?
No, yep, that also shows up. We've tested it in this game. You can get shit,
smoke.
Piss, cum.
Smoke?
Haven't tried smoke. Cup of God. Cup of Joe, which is a cup of blood. Cup of blood you'll get.
Cup of Satan.
We haven't tried Satan.
Look, if there's going to be Cup of God as an option, surely.
Well, that's because God
Satan
is an SCP.
Yeah, but surely Satan is.
But
one
trust,
too.
You get a cup of God. As in. You get a cup of that SCP.
What about, what happens if you get a cup of 001? SCP 001.
Well, that's an interesting question, because the problem is, there are at least 20 different SCP-001s.
What about, what's the highest top, the god of being, of, what's the term
so
of
here's
gameplay?
The problem, because in SCP, there are several different SCP-001.
I'm talking the one with just as giant as being, the one, I think.
Trust, one of the SCPs is the fucking sun. Alright, I don't...
Wait, what happens if we get the cup of sun? As in S-U-N. Do you get a blast of radiation?
So anyway, let's see all the SCP-00. So as a kid, it was so dumb. But if, when you go to 001, they're like, non-authorized personnel, accident file will be immediately terminated through Brian Longford, medic kill agent. Scroll down without proper medic inoculation will result in immediate cardiac cardiac arrest followed by death. And then it's like,
nice.
They have a PNG of some stuff, and it's like, yeah, confirmed, life size confirmed, you're fine. However,
yep.
One of the SCPs is the SCP Foundation itself, because they're like, yeah. This shit's on the internet, and none of our shit stops you from looking at it.
So what happens if you just, what's the SCP where it's just this giant
newly declassified.
Giant
ooh, there's three new ones. Touching Eternity, ethical considerations with regard to former inhabitants of 881 Galatian 2 and SCP Cevalon equation known as Sword Stars, and then the Throne of God. Anyway, there's Shelf of Papers, the Human Element, Ouroboros, the Spiral Path, Project Paladus, the Conspiracy, Test of Character, A Good Boy, Simple Toymaker, You Are an Abnormality, Tumor of the World, Story of Your Life, When Day Breaks, the Database, The World's Gone Beautiful, Ethical Consideration with the Former Inhabitants, blah, 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 yeah, we've already seen that, Fish Hooks, Foundation, The Gate Guardian, Dead Men, Touching Eternity, Mento Memoriam, The Prototype, Solution, The Queen's Gambit, A Record, Mementos, Legacy, Malzure, Keller, Kelter Duty, The Sky Above the Port. Tauto's Trinity, Normalcy, Placeholder, God's Blind Spot, the Font is Space, the Locks, the One That Got Away, the Problem, the Census, the Past and Future, Last Ride of the Day, 0513, the Black Moon, the World at Large, Rage, the Factory, 13-6, the Scarlet Key, and Amun Ram. There's so many SCP-001s because...
I thought of something so horrifying.
In order to prevent the knowledge of SCP-001 from being leaked, several or none of them, false SCP-001 files have been created alongside true files, alongside the true files. All files concerning the nature of SCP-001, including the decoys, are predicted by the mech kill agent designed to immediately cause cardiac arrest and non-authorized personnel to be accessed to file. Revealing the true natures of SCP-001 to the general public is cause for execution, except as required under the... So yeah, all of these, or none of these, could be completely bullshit. Though, we do know this. The Scarlet King is real, because one SCP is literally designed to kill him. The Factory is real, because several SCPs are come from the Factory. And the Garden of Eden could be real, because it's basically one of the archangels of God from the Bible protecting the Garden of Eden entrance. Anyone who comes near it, they wipe them out. Like, at one point, like, a Chinese sub launches a missile as a test. Not against it, but just in general. And it looks over and cuts the missile in half, which also cuts the sub in half, blowing it up instantly.
So it's basically straight out of an anime.
Yeah, basically. It's just like, it's how none of us can ever go in the Garden of Eden, because that motherfucker will make sure of it. The Foundation, we think, is also real, because we find it fascinating. So the Foundation, not the SCP Foundation, but at one point they found a building, right? And when they sent people in, it would kind of... sometimes it would, like, either Valor and clone them, or it would just, like, it would make a copy, like, a clone of that person who entered. And at one point, because they sent so many SCP members in there, it literally became the SCP Foundation, and they sent a message to the Foundation, like, we're the real Foundation. Stop sending guys in here, or we'll be forced to contain you. And the Foundation's like, no, we're the real one. They're like, no, we are. And both groups, like... So we're just gonna leave them be? We're gonna let them do their own shit?
So, I don't know why I find that funny to me. It's like the Spider-Man meme.
That's literally what it was. It was fucking that. Hold on, I wanna look at it again.
Just the Spider-Man meme, SCP edition.
Like, remember at the... Blah, blah, blah.
Wait, what happens if you put the building inside the building?
Okay, the usual infidence, so, let's read this, because this is actually a lot shorter than we remember it being. Alternative high school building in confirmed anomaly 3, highly intrusive, unknown capabilities, unknown nature, confirmed anomaly 3 is to be surrounded by blah, 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 blah. It's cut out, so that doesn't work. Under no circumstances should any personnel attempt to enter CA3 or communicate with the person inhabiting it. However, any person known to have been inside CA3 at any point must be detained and interrogated. A direct military assault on SA3 has been deemed unfeasible at this point due to the unknown capabilities of the entity and entities by which it is controlled. This is a summary and does not contain all information relevant to CA3. For detailed information regarding CA3, see UA files 0042 through 218 Director. The usual instance unit was alerted to CA3's incident when students attending the high school per the interior of the building was vastly different than it had been in the past. Upon discovery, nearly all the walls of the facility had been replaced with steel-reinforced concrete, although several rooms were constructed of materials for no readily apparent reason. All exterior windows had been covered from the inside. All student desks, personal effects, textbooks, and other materials expected of a public high school were completely absent. Lockers were still present, albeit significantly smaller and constructed of stainless steel. The arrangement location, blah, 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 did not match the blueprints of the school, blah, blah, blah. No fewer than 17 electron computers were found, which made a state-of-the-art magnet, so they were fancy computers. The auditorium is inaccessible due to a large steel wall completely blocking the doorways. Attempts to move and damage the barrier have been ineffective. The extent and purpose of the barrier are unknown, as are the contents of the auditorium. Team sent into CA3, blah, blah, blah. Did not. The team sent into CA3's interior to do a complete survey, team CA305, did not return, nor did the second team, 06, tasked with locating the first team. The facilities are currently under lockdown pending new containment protocols. 23 days after initial recovery, guards reported white noise emanating from CA3, the volume of which increased near its auditorium. 5 hours later, the white noise stopped, although the sounds of voices were audible from the interior of CA3. Upon further investigation, it was found the building now contained a large number of persons, all of whom appeared to be wandering aimlessly through the facility. Notably, each individual was physically identical to the member of CA306. Despite the inhabitants of CA3 vastly outnumbering the members of so there's more people in there than there was on the team. Attempts to interview or detain the inhabitants were thwarted by classified. The 12 members of CA305 were never found. In addition to aforementioned interior layout, the CA3 has changed significantly since the previous investigations. No mechanisms could explain what has been identified. Update. 3 months after the previous incident, white noise was again heard emanating. This time, it was found that most of the CA302 that emanated, given the inhabitants of CA3, were gathered near the doors of the auditorium. A circular hole roughly 6 feet in diameter had formed the steel barrier, although the interior was not visible. At 03:10, an item resembling a classified emerged from the hole and was carried away by the inhabitants. It was placed in one of the classrooms, which had not been previously observed to be open. This process continued for upwards of 8 hours, with new items being produced every 3 minutes. Wasn't entering a different room or locker, although different personnel were able to track all items. Further investigations revealed that most, if not all, of the items produced exhibited anomalous properties themselves. A significant portion of CA32 were involved in either guarding the items produced collectively, CA3-3, or performing various tests on them. Update. 2 days after the previous incident, three identical armed guards appeared near each entrance of CA3. Further attempts to enter the building were futile, as these guards have constantly overpowered all teams sent to enter CA3, regardless of injury or relative level of armament. Note, reports gathered during the 2 days prior to the guards manifesting CA3 appeared to confirm that CA3-2 is following standard UIU protocol regarding the item procedure by the auditorium. The knowledge of the UIU standard procedure is constant with that of CA3-05. Update. During the UIU's tracking of CA6, two identical men to Agent Dixon, a member of CA3-06, emerged from a parked car and forcibly detained CA6, dragging him away in a car and driving away. Tracking the vehicle for 8 hours revealed that it was driving directly to CA3. Upon arrival, the vehicle drove through the front doors, which the guards had opened shortly after the arrival. CA6 has not been recovered. UA file message received from CA3. On May 15th, the following message was transmitted from the Morse code from CA3 on standard UIU communication frequencies. Sensitive data has been classified and beginning of each sentence has been capitalized, but the message has not been changed otherwise. Hello, we are the O5 Council and we secure, contain, protect. We have been shown to do, and it would be nice to be friends. It has been nice to be part of your excellent, but it is best that with our superior resources, given the greatness, we control the containment. Our sincerest apologies regarding guards and detainment workers and secrets kept needed. The time and waits, we apologize. The radio blocked by one SCP or two. Expect an expansion soon, for we space for alternative away from the auditorium. Okay, but unwanted. 8 hours later, the phone transmitter is received. Expanded now. See, the federal building is now functional. Need doctors, guards, demon recruiting. Anomalies found in further possessed international recording of course possible international maybe days, weeks to do. Further, we, O5, are aware, sorry of O6 missed, the legible buried, but need to go, but go between auditorium, not goodbye, and good luck with your trouble and luck with your troubles. Information to see UFO alter. I fucking love how they're just like, hold on, there's a fucking citation. Communism will win. Anyway, we were like, yeah, we'd love to be friends. Anyway, sorry about all the people we stole. Oopsie daisies. Bit of a oopsie daisy. But yeah, no, they're literally a facility of like, clearly as you can see from that, they're not quite right because their sentence grammar was fucked. But they're also not brain dead. They know how the SCPs work. They know they need guard scientist D class. And they... Well, Dress, much like Woden, or much like the Black Sheep, looks like you have two hallways. But this hallway isn't open.
What?
You're right. That's one of our more favorite SCPs. Just because it's the foundation. But it's not.
Attention.
But we love how they're like, we don't want to be enemies.
Immediately.
Oh, fuck, we need that. Now, if only we had that key card.
Yeah, now, I'm curious if we put the cup of sun in there, as in the radiation.
You're a piece of shit, you know that.
You didn't see the peanut
boy.
Oh,
I'm sorry, you did, fucker? Hold on. There we go. You know what? No, you don't.
What?
I was gonna make the map scene Crimson's better ass. Damn.
How about Crimson's ass?
Well, if you'll slap it.
Do you think I can't slap a map?
We think that Crimson thinks you're too much of a pussy to do it. There you go.
I can't slap surface area.
All the Callies laugh. You can't slap a surface area? Pathetic! Hey guys, can we come too?
Guys, can I die too?
Funny enough, if you sprint up to him, we think he just shoots you.
Huh.
So we're not going. Fuck, let's go this way. What did we name this map?
I think Crimson's ass, I think.
So apparently Crimson's left cheek composes of four SCPs, which is considering she had to fight infinitely against an Elder God. No, not
yeah,
an Elder
that's
God.
Like, but
considering she had to fight against the spawn of an Elder being that was unkillable. Yeah, fuck you, robot. Open the door. Also,
attention.
Oh.
Where's the spooky boy? How's the boy?
Immediately.
So far, Warden has been the best. It's just we fucked up. Cause that infinite hallway spawned a goddamn perfect key card. We can't play with half the SCPs we saw because of it.
Nice! Oh yeah, this thing!
Okay, so swear to God, at work, we've seen this SCP. Like no meme. We've seen, like, on the way to work today, in our car, we swear we saw, like, a wasp or a bug in our car, and we blinked and turned around, and there was just nothing there. And when we got to work several times on the wall, there was a bug that didn't exist.
Nice.
AK, this fucker.
Nice.
Bugs are real. Keep money Wait. Like that and we'll make you give have reason to know.
That ancient speak is not my tongue.
I'm closing that. Goodbye.
Peanut! Welcome back!
We'll be going this way now.
Did I see the bear?
Nope. The bear does spawn in that room. Shit. The peanut despawned by now. You know, there is another SCP game.
Where?
And maybe we'll play it next horror game. But there is another SCP game we have called The Daughter of Shadows, which is a 2D SCP containment breach game where you play as an SCP trying to breach. Wow, Tress, so far you're Woden's ass is about as hard as we thought it would be. AK, firm and tight. By God, she wants us to meet the fucking shy guy. Oh shit, we can go this way. Go over here. That's about right. We get what we fucking deserve. That scream's not real. And thus, the one where we got a key card was the best reality. Because we can't go into half of these fucking buildings. On the other hand, this is about how secure we believe a facility should be. We got a key card, thank God. Goodbye. We'll be back. You gotta be fucking kidding. Peanut, please. Goodbye! Okay, now that you're down there. We're already dead. You might as well quit. I'm going back to Woden 2. At least I had a goddamn key card in that one. The beast. Oh yeah, do we mention the old man calls? Ah. You know what? You know what, Trust? You know what we've been fucking up? You know why we've been fucking up? Because Woden's not ready yet. You know who is ready? Good fucking luck. Don't need to use the handle. They're not just Keter, they handle everything. Also, Tress, did you die? You understand you're here to tell us when when Limbus Company comes up, right?
Maybe. Maybe not. Who knows?
Crimson Pimp Slap Shrew Rebuild. Oh, there you go.
Oh, okay.
You understand who's in charge now? Guys, can we come too? Yeah, we deserve that. So, Callie.
Oh.
Callie's the only one who could deal with this. So are you getting worn out from having to commentate over us having to deal with this bullshit?
No, I was actually doing physical things. Oh. Like picking up an object.
Trust, you have to understand how much we don't want to be mean. You picked up an object.
And?
Looks at the entire bed that we had to pick up while also not being physically fit. Yeah?
There's a difference between picking up on a bed and picking up from the damn floor.
We mean we had to, move every object in our room, including an entire fucking dresser. I'm just saying, like...
Look, I ain't fit.
You ain't thick? I don't know about that fit. One. Okay, cool, because if you said you weren't thick... I'm sorry, you know what, Triss, how about we go ahead and... you know what, Triss? We're not gonna bully you. We could've. Oh, don't do that.
Look, I recognize I am indeed thick!
Oh, Crimson knows that. Make no mistake.
My weight shows that I am thick! And you know what? I'm going to burn the damn thing off when I get on my birthday.
You know what,
and there's
Trust?
A reason for it.
You know what, Trust? Do you have any weights? Like, even weak weights? Do you have anything that could be considered a 10-pound thing that you could mess with?
Other than the gallons of milk.
You know, grab some milk.
Do you want me to grunt right on stream?
No, because Trust, we have 15-pound weights. And we know the one song that will make you want to become buff as fuck.
Bold of you to assume I want to be buff.
Bold of you to think that the song Macho Macho Man won't make you want to be buff as fuck. You know what, chat? No, hold on. We're going to play it on stream. You know what, Tress? You don't even have to go grab the gallons of milk. You tell us if you want to become buff as shit after these 5 minutes. You play that song, though. Are you ready?
Astral, I want to pet the dog.
Fuck off. So anyway, you ready to play that? Because it's from the Village Men, aka YMCA.
And then fight the dog.
You want to fight the dog?
If that's what the desire to be, to have a fight, I would do the fight. But I'm just saying, I would pet the dog first.
Stress, are you going to listen to Macho Man, or are we going to be sitting here going Macho Macho Man for about 5 minutes? You know what, Tress? Come on, come along with us. You don't have to do a damn thing, but you listen to that song. Listen, look at the music video, because that's some shit. And also, that's the YMCA people, the one that was the YMCA gay as fuck. You know what, chat? We want to be a macho, macho man. Fuck off, Disney H. Why the fuck is Wally? What the fuck? Huh? I saw Wally next to the Mandalorian. Anyway, you know, Trust. Let's get buff tonight.
No build
my body. Listen to those first few seconds at least. Come on. That's some shit.
I have listened to it, is the thing.
Isn't it beautiful? Also, we're trying to get, because in order to get rid of like a weed and alcohol addiction, they do say when you're here for cravings, start pumping iron. Watch your man! Anyway, Tress, if Joe was to become buff, or to work out, by God, could you imagine that? Macho man, I want to be a macho man. Not to disrespect anyone's body type, but come on now. We think most thick or obese people, much like us, we have a lot of muscle under a lot of our thickness. Could you imagine the muscles? The amount of people you could rip in half. Could you imagine the crimson level strength you could have? Alright, that's enough of that. I got 2 minutes in, yeah, that's about right. Yeah, it's about how pathetic we are. Anyway, the point is stress. You wanna get buff? We'll make you buff. Or not buff, but if you wanna get in shape, you listen to some Village People. We look over at the YMCA. I could pump iron to the YMCA.
I had to do with Night of Nights.
Also pretty good, but come on. A song telling you to be a macho, macho man? With the music video being literally macho men pumping iron?
Can we just start with the SCP thing again?
We are.
I was picking up a god freaking...
Good. You know what, Tress? Whatever you're picking up and being buff with, keep that up. Because as Bluesy would tell you, it's always worth it. Because Bluesy is a 5-foot-tall fucking midget man. They're 5-foot-tall, you know what? They have a kid. They fuck. Anyway, the point is, don't you want to have a physical physique to where you could pick up the peanut and huck it 15 miles away? We do. Macho, macho man. I wanna be a macho man. Of course, with their famous other one, YMCA. I wanna go to the YMCA. Well, that was used to show all humans. We remember that. Alright, where the fuck are we going? What seed is this? Ah, we remember what seed this is. You know what?
What seed is it?
It's you, Tress. This is your seed. This is your seed. This door's open this time.
Nice.
Macho, macho man. I wanna be
attention.
Macho man. Macho, macho man.
Immediately.
What's that?
Huh? Don't worry about it.
I could've sworn I saw a security area.
No, you didn't.
No, I saw some weird fancy logo.
Well, fuck.
We're in the funky zone.
Howdy, howdy.
Hi, Peanut. How you doing?
We'll be not going that way now. Goodbye.
Bad luck behind you.
Nah, he wouldn't be here.
You sure?
stress, at this point, he would have snapped us in half like a fucking twig.
What say he hasn't done, can't do it now?
Because he can't move if we look at him.
But you're not looking at him.
Exactly.
Who's saying that you can move?
God.
You know, I would like a cup of fun now.
Okay, we're gonna be taking that.
Wait, what would a cup of insects look like?
A cup of insects?
From the SCP.
No, we mean. A cup of insects, I guess?
Would it grind up the insects? Or would it just... Hi there!
Maybe.
I mean, technically it would grind up the insects, wouldn't it? Hi, Peanut. Hi, Peanut.
So we'll be going this way. That's fine. Never mind.
Well, yeah, just... I'm trying to think of some wacky-ass things you can put in that tiny little cup.
We're trying to think of how in 2 minutes the fucking update happens.
I mean, I'm gonna check it once it reaches that 2 hours, yeah. Of 2 minutes.
And Tress, thus you and Crimson's ass, as phenomenal as it is not as good as Woad. Because at least she got a level 2 keycard by this point. Which meant we get to have fun. The Abnormalities.
I don't know about you, but it's very interesting looking through the insides of my ass.
Let me say that again. What is this?
You can't say them look inside my ass.
Hold on. Bare nothing.
Is there an SCP that's just radio static?
There's a Parched Moon abnormality that is.
What?
You're listening to SCP Foundation on site.
Remember?
Your 24/7 source.
Where?
The one that, like, if you piss it off, it makes stack to the whole facility that drains your sanity.
I'm talking here in the SCP Foundation.
Yeah, but we're saying there's the Lobotomy Corp one, and all of Project Moon is based off of this shit. So fucking maybe we got
to
through
smoke
there.
Man? What does the smoke man smoke do?
The smoke is just decontamination smoke, but we could get locked in there and suffocate to death.
They truly provide no breathing room here.
Yeah, Trish, your ass is kind of dog shit.
At least you got somewhere new.
You know what? Yeah, at least we got somewhere new that we still can't interact with because we have no fucking keycard. Never mind. No, we didn't. We went in a fucking circle.
Hi, Peanut. Bye, Peanut.
So we're gonna go Black Sheep one more time, because that one at least gave us a key card that was allowed us.
Red Sheep?
No.
Yellow Sheep.
No. Because at least this one gave us a level 2 key card.
Black Sheep, White Sheep, Red Sheep, Blue Sheep?
Like, legitimately, every other thing we've done has given us a level 1, which doesn't do dick. Oh, well, we were gonna look at it, but our sensitivity's too good.
Hi, Peanut. Bye, Peanut.
There's a key card in here. Sometimes there's a file in here. That paper's not real, but sometimes that paper can be something. Go this way.
That screaming is nice.
Your mom's screaming is nice. Got him!
I need my cup of Joes!
Oh, Trish, it's funny you think that's gonna appear anytime this stream.
No, I'm talking the SCP.
We know. It's funny you think that's gonna appear anytime.
Wait, what happens if you get the cup of the old man SCP?
Now, Trust, when we get to the actual, like, normal part of the facility that isn't this bullshit, we'll be happy to let you know.
Seriously, I wonder what the hell the cup of the old man would look like.
I mean, there's console commanding it.
Yeah, but what the hell would the cup of the old man look like?
Oh. Never did it. That's
nope.
What we're saying.
Go on the maintenance. Things on the maintenance still.
Okay.
Fine, anyway. I wonder what the cup of the cup of the peanut would look like.
Goodbye,
then probably
fucker.
Be off stone. I think the cup of the peanut would probably look a bit stoned. In a little
sense.
You
think that cup of that peanut's fucking stuck in that goddamn shelf. Also, there was like a whole chat thing happening. And you just wonder in the dark of anyone else, the fluorescent lights suddenly switch on. What came up in the view was a beagle, sitting on two legs, wearing shorts and two boxing gloves. He appeared to be a ring fighter, if you believe it. I used to be a ring champion in these parts. Wolf, I've gotten old. Long time and glory days of my prime. Dream an old dog with one last fight. Wolf, fight the dog, pet the dog. Broden chooses to fucking throw down with the dog.
I don't know about you, but I chose.
So Pompidou wants to throw down, then Pompidou's gonna get my foot in his ass. Why are we, what?
Shocking.
No, hold on, something forced us to look over there. The hell? There's some abnormalities that do that. Or that's a glitch. Okay. Through higher, gotcha. Somewhere is the up. That's the one thing, chat, is before we go to Nimbus Comp. Don't go there! Well, he's dead. Sure. Nope. Yeah, right. Wasn't there a... God damn it, hold on. We have to go back. Gotta go back. Back to the past. Samurai Jack. There it is. Okay. Because in here, not in here, further back to the past.
I think the shortest way out is through the southeast wing. Follow me. Did you hear that?
Perfect. We walked past it, didn't we? Okay, Assuming Fuckboy doesn't show up, we can read this SCP now. Hold on. First, you there. You fuck off. You fuck off. There. 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 Oh, God forbid you keep the wallet. Okay. Has variable depths of changes occurred? User or portion? Triss!
Where?
It's the whole lore. There's seeming reason the depths of the earth that their arms allow. Okay. So it eats what we give it. Hmm. What did we just get? A gas mask. Okay. So in that case, get everything else off of us. Just this. So it ate my goddamn clipboard. You know what? Hold on. Got an idea. Oh, God damn it. Okay. Okay. Go away. Go away. Stay. Go away. Go. Go away. Keep. Okay.
I get the hole in the wall.
What is this?
You too can feed the hole in the wall.
Origami? It is connected in. Okay, something about 008. Electronical components, who cares?
Nice! You got a code!
You did?
It did have a code.
A MasterCard?
Where are we taking that?
The face.
What? Oh, okay.
Well.
What's that? Is that the SCP key?
Who's to say, Tress? Who's to say? Either way, it's a key we'll be keeping. Even better. Isn't the key that old check the one right? No. It can't be.
Okay.
Well, that key's going in there.
You know, you should have kept the old key code, the master key code thing.
We have it. No, the MasterCard is like a credit card.
Ah!
Which is the worst thing you can get from the monster.
I thought it was just a master key card. No,
that key card is... That key card is the 05 key card.
Ah.
Here it is.
Just Smithy place. Save.
First, med kit. Hell yeah. Second, that.
You better save.
Okay, we got an idea. Tress, we have an idea. So, the best is that, right?
Maybe?
Is fine. Is very fine, right? Because course, a rough turn a chimpanzee into meat, right? So, if we do this, that means we're the best. Which means, if Woden does this...
Isn't it by the other end, though?
Oh, fuck, you're right. So if we do... Then we become perfect. If we do very fine, Tress, we become perfect. Let's get the hell out of here, chat.
Oh, that's a lot of speed.
We become perfect.
Oh.
That is bullshit blazing. Still, my heart is blazing.
What happens if you put perfect twice on yourself?
Tress, you don't understand what's happening, do you?
Nope.
That is bullshit blazing. Still my heart is bright. So when we became cocaine.
Patty, you were too, not quick enough.
No. So genuinely what happens is you become a powder of fine mist. You become a blue powder.
Which means you died.
No, yeah, right? You die. But you become this bluish powder.
What happens if you escape as that blue powder?
You can't. We're at the start. You can only get this thing at the start of the game. You die long before you get out of heavy containment. Anyway, so that's what happens if you do that. It literally says you turn into, a blue sandy powder. We found a blue sandy powder around a D-class uniform. Not sure what that's about. Also, let's see what happens. So let's put a couple things in here. Let's put this in here. Let's put this in here. Let's put this in here. On very fine...
You better put it on very fine, boy.
What's the slap your ass? Is Heathcliff's bullshit up yet?
I mean, I could test it. I've already tried it 15 minutes ago.
Yeah, but 15... Still a gas mask. Strange Ball, that's a full heal. And MasterCard.
Strange what?
The Strange Ball is a full heal.
Oh.
That's you're good. And it does it fast because it's a bottle, not a med kit, where you have to do all that bullshit.
Huh.
Two. So what if we did this, but only went to very fine. Would you believe on the wiki there's actually a whole guide to how this shit works?
Well, still in the maintenance. Well.
It might be 10 then. That's... Oh, yeah, because of daylight saving times. Without daylight saving times, it would have actually been... right now. Well, I don't know why I'm bothering. I'm the one alive, I think. Or maybe... Okay, Tress. You know what? Let's... We want to bullshit this. Mostly where? Because this gives us a lot of abnormalities, so look up the wiki. How do we make SCP-4? This make God? This is SCP... 914. In Containment Breach, how do we make the best thing ever? Do be fast, because the old man will come eventually. Let's put 9-volt battery in here.
I'm just looking at the input. What's fine? Wait.
D9341 found dead inside 91's alpha booth next to what appears to be an ordinary 9-volt battery. Subject covered in severe electrical burns, assumed to be killed via electroshock caused by the battery. The battery's been stored for further study. Yeah, we put a battery in there and put it on find, and we made it a super battery.
Nice!
Oops, forgot about that. Anyway, as you were saying...
I mean, I'm looking at the site and it doesn't seem to say...
Not on the site, look at the wiki for Containment Breach. So what if we put the key in there? What is the key? I don't play Backrooms games so bad. So many of them cost money or are so hard to find because they're all this fucking same. Okay. We have an idea.
Where?
We're gonna put the wall in there. We got time. You know, it's funny, because in Secret Labs, the 7 abnormality still exists. It's not controlled by a player, it's just something that exists. But it's fascinating that in that game, you could still do this shit.
Hmm.
Like, thus the enemies have a chance to fuck with you.
Do you mind if I take a break before the other show starts?
Trust, we want you to tell us how this shit works before you go. Do you understand how many abnormalities we have to figure out for this shit? This is like half the game. It's not half the game. But it is like, we can make this key card go from level 2. The only thing is we want to at least get a level 3 off of this, because that is how you can activate half the... We genuinely want to see half the abnormalities in here, but some of them will be like, no, you need a level 3, and you're supposed to get a level 3 from this guy. You can get... And the only reason... The only way you can activate a nuke is by using this guy. Level 5 on the gas mask, God willing. Fun fact, if you use the SCP gas mask on this, you take away its ability to, like, transport you, but you get infinite stamina. Actually, we think we just did that anyway. You put on the gas mask and you can breathe easier. Yeah, we can sprint forever now. We have this effect, but we can sprint forever now.
Ralph often dismantles and or destroys the item entirely. Chorus dismantles in the thoughts, one by one, gives an item the equal use and function. Refines items and usually improves them with anomalous feature. Very fine. Usually gives a heavily anomalous version of items. Some items can be deadly, while some can be more useful than the default of fine counterparts. So I would assume you need to put the fine for the key card.
We did that. It put it in his MasterCard. Alright, let's keep moving. Trust, you're not allowed to leave yet. Because there was four SCPs earlier, weren't there? We can activate them. We want to see what they did. Because you might have some thoughts on them. That is level 3, isn't it? Yep. Nope. No, that's testing. That's where we got this guy. We want to at least find the SCP. There was like a hallway that had like four or five SCPs in it. At least we know how to run fast. If we put on our gas mask, we can sprint forever. We put this one on because now it's a better gas mask. Wish the thing was in there. Okay, we should be able to open this, right? Nope. We'll be back. F5, we save. Let's see what's going on there.
What?
You gotta be fucking kidding.
Ooh, you sure shrunk like an ocean.
Bone uses her powers of manipulation. Say fuck that. No, I didn't. Yeah, if you walk into the funny old man's goop, you explode. Also, another reason we need level 3. Level 3 to get in there. And that's how you're supposed to get it from off of that. You need to, you have to fuck with that monster to get some better shit. Let's see, where are we? Or, fuck! Alright, let's keep going. We haven't seen the hallway with the monsters yet. You gotta be fucking kidding. Back we go!
Indeed.
Our options are hallway that gives us the abnormality that lets us have fun, or when the valiant fucking attempt, my man. I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Tress, well, we're back there because you know you're gonna be there for Limbus Company. Tell us, what do you think's gonna happen? What do you think we're gonna find under the basement while we're gone? What is, based off what you think, here's our thoughts. We think Catherine faked her death to a degree, found a Limbus Company thing under her mansion, or was funding a Limbus Company thing under her mansion for the brightest days to try and get Heathcliff back. Tell us, what do you think is going to be in the mansion?
I mean, what I assume would be the mansion is I would assume, be either two things, a laboratory or some weird ass shit down there. Well, somehow you can see the body of the Catherine and yet it's not there at all. What I mean by that, I mean, she transformed into a distortion. But her whole body's there, meaning everybody's assuming she's already dead, but she's not there dead at all. And that's why everybody would be able to hear her voice, because no one ever seems to go down to that basement. Not what we've seen. Because, yes, in the Otis thing, they do come down there, but that's because that was before all this mess started. So I would assume something is in there and just kind of just residing in there, essentially acting like the puppet to all of this madness,
and that's why the letter was written to Heathcliff. This distortion managed to write that said note. Because it's always the castle. I don't know if this makes any sense or not, but I assume she transformed into this creature of some sort. If is that?
Didn't we fucked off? But we assume it was very entertaining what you said. We heard something about a creature. There's gonna be a fucking creature down
there. What I assume what happens was, like, we'll find the body of Castlin, but somehow she's not dead because she has been transformed. And that's how she became.
We think Catherine has either faked her death. Okay, here's okay. Yep. And while going to go piss, we thought about this while sitting down. Catherine saw the Brightest Days event happen because, in the original story for Heathcliff, Catherine is dead right now. Heathcliff finds out Catherine's dead and then fucking kills everyone. He does it slowly, surely, and methodically. And then after he dies, Nancy, the maid, sees Catherine Heathcliff as ghosts throughout the mansion, actually being together. Heathcliff's not going to kill himself at the end of this, believe it or not.
I mean, he's sure going to want to, though.
We don't think he is, because in that one, it is confirmed, like, he doesn't do this whole, she's not dead, thing, because he comes back alone, and he sees the corpse. And at one point, he digs up the body, and he sees it, and he's like, oh. So I'm going to kill everyone now. And it's implied that he went through World War I to get prestige. And after he came back from World War I, he's like, and I come back to this shit? Nah, I'm killing everyone. And a World War I veteran soldier versus rich fuckboy and drunk fuckboy. Yeah, right. Couldn't hide the body.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I assume in that sense, we'll just murder the both of them somehow.
That's in the original story. But in this, as people said, he does that because he's so fucking pissed them at, like, you let her die. Because it is said in the original story, she says, I love you, but you're not of high class. Which, we get it's a writing style to say, like, it might be blunt, but it's like, yeah, it's still, like, it's supposed to mean, like, she does actually love him, but because of the status of the time, she can't be with him.
Well, yeah.
But in this world, it's like, that don't work. Don't die watching you stream. That's what you think. When was that? 5 minutes ago? That's fine. But we think in this one, it's going to be that she's not dead. Because even the rich guy who was her husband was trying to go in deep with it and has never fully explained. We think she's alive, but distorted.
That's what I assume as well when I mean by creature. Because I would assume she must have found a way to distort herself.
We think what happened was the Brightest Day event happened. And then it stopped. And she felt something. Everyone felt something. So she felt her connection with Heathcliff. Felt he was alive. And then made a test for him.
Which is what I assume, like, the distortion thing happened. Because I have said when you were gone, she, like, in her distorted form, she must have written something. And how the hell is that note still possible if it's not
you? We think she wrote all that beforehand and then hid it because only Heathcliff would know it was in her pillow, as childish as it was.
No, I'm talking the start of it.
What was the start?
Like, I'm talking before we even got into that mansion.
Here's the thing. We think she wrote everything down in her diary, hid it, and then the diary became distorted as well. And hiding the effects from people.
That's probably what is happening, but I'm talking the note that was on the bus.
No, we think she sent that, but...
Yeah, I'm saying...
The letter might have been delayed, as in, whoever's in charge knows how this is going to work out, because she sent that clearly when she was still, quote-unquote, alive, and he just now got it, and it just now happened to tell him, oh, there's a ball happening right fucking now, and then everyone gets there at the exact... No. So, the letter was meant to be delayed. Or it was going to be sent to Heathcliff.
But
then the
distortions
happened. And everyone went, hold the fuck on. Because
a lot of
these characters are dealing with their trauma like they do in the books. But then something stops them from going full out fucked up. Like, Grigor is supposed to be a bug man at the end. A full roach that nobody loves. Rodian is... I don't fucking know. Kills someone, gets killed. I don't give a shit. Yi Sang is a poet during World War II. But Heathcliff and Ishmael... Ishmael is...
And I assume, like, in this case, like, the Ishmael and Ahab thing was based on the...
Everything that happened, up till the boat breaking in her backstory is canon. That happens. Even her wanting to fuck...
Kweefoff?
Yep, that one. That's canon. There's a very... like, intense romantic relationship with that. Heathcliff, the part we're watching the story happen is canon to the book, for the most part. Project Moon's doing their whole spin on it.
Yeah.
But Heathcliff coming back after, quote-unquote, making a name for himself with the company, only to come back to a funeral, that's canon. Because the book, he leaves... because he wants to make a name for himself, and it's implied he comes back after World War I, back to a funeral. And he gets it sprung on him. But then we have the dead rabbits. We have butlers and
yeah,
maids. We have... and then everyone cannot tell him straight to his face she's dead. In the original book, they're like, no, she's dead. And he chooses not believe it's real. To the point he digs her up. But people in the story so far have been going, yeah, I guess. Yeah. I haven't seen the body. But...
I mean, yeah.
And then her husband's like, yeah, she's dead. I guess. I wanted her notebook. Oh, she chose you in it. Okay, you can go on. Well, suspicious, isn't it?
Yeah.
Especially since the Brightest Days event would have happened 10 years ago. When does Heathcliff leave? Heathcliff was a child. He grew up. All of the sinners, we assume, live through the Brightest Days event. So, when Heathcliff left... it would have had to been after the Brightest Days event.
I would assume so.
Or before the Brightest Days. The Brightest Days event happened after he left Catherine. And then her mood seemingly improved. 10 years ago. Well, actually, okay, when is Library of Runa to Limbus Company?
Good question, actually.
Because Lobotomy Corp happens it happens for the duration of 10 years. Heathcliff was a child before Lobotomy Corp. So Heathcliff would, if we were saying he got adopted 10 years before, he would have been a 16-year-old during the Brightest Days event. At the very least, his backstory would have happened, and Sinclair's backstory had to have happened for those events. So our thought process is Heathcliff, Sinclair, all their stories happened. And then their last memories, where it's the worst part, where in their stories, the worst thing that could have happened, happened. The brightest days happened before that. And thus, every character that could have fucked up and done something bad changed their mind, except Cromer, Ahab, Herman. They refuse, and like the werewolf girl, which there's a funny porn thing, Tress. I want to send it to you, but it's like, it's Carmen going up to Tanya, the werewolf girl, and just whispering, "Distort, distort," in her ear. And then she goes to Futokak and fucks Carmen. But we love the idea of Carmen going up to someone just going, "Distort, distort." It's like, yeah, that's basically what happened.
Yeah.
But we think that's what happened for the Blue Reveration. They're irredeemable because their stories didn't have a happy... Like, the Blue Reveration, with how... When Carmen would have happened, there's no way he gets a happy ending. Because he doesn't trust Roland, and his sister's dead. Everyone's angry. Roland, however, overcame that adversity. The Blue Reverberation just didn't. He fed into it. The Clown Boy, I don't know what his backstory is, but he fed into it. Tanya fed into it. Elena and all the others, because Elena, Tanya, the puppet dude, they're not abnormalities, they're distortions. They fed into their pain. The one gear girl is a distortion, not an abnormality. The Blue Reverberation recruited distortions. We all float down here.
Yeah.
So we think Catherine had the brightest day event. Instead of distorting, desperately held on to wanting to meet Heathcliff again. Because as the one dude said, he burned all of Heathcliff's letters. If you remember, after you beat him, he's like, "All those letters you sent, I burned them."
Yeah, I do remember that, because I remember commenting about that. But yet,
she still knows how to send a letter to him, despite he would not have let her send a single goddamn letter. But somehow that letter got through. Maybe she knew. Or maybe her distortion broke through everything. Limbus Company, we think, is connected to Lobotomy Corporation.
Probably.
Oh no, this definitely is, somehow. But her letter getting through, because when Heathcliff comes back in the original story, he wants to meet Catherine, but she's dead, so he gets revenge and kills everyone. The fact in the story we saw, he doesn't beat that one man to fucking death when the maids could have done it for him. The fact he wants to protect everyone and it's fighting through his rage. In the original story, he does revenge plots to fuck everyone. Besides Nancy. We think she is still alive. Or at the very least, she is the Golden Burrow. And she knew she turned into a Golden Burrow. And she wants him to kind of move on. The thing he couldn't do in life. Also, Heathcliff is the devil, but who knows? I don't fucking know. No, legitimately, in the original story, it is implied he's supposed to be the devil.
Yeah, can we just play the SCP thing again?
we would, but... We're gonna jump up real quick, Dress, and you're out of the leaf, because our food has definitely finished heating up the first time, and we need to heat up the second time. Have you not had a TV dinner?
Yes.
Have you cooked a TV dinner?
Nope.
Okay, so the TV dinner we cooked several minutes ago, heat up for 4 minutes, take off the film or move back the film, and then heat up for 3 more minutes. We've been talking during the second part. That's why it's like we get so nervous about leaving because we're scared people are gonna leave.
Ah.
We would have done that long ago and already had the food to cool off, because once we have it, we have to cool it off. But that's what we're saying. You're not allowed to leave because it'd take us like this house isn't that big. It'll just a second. We'll be right back. We just have to go remove the film, stir it, and be right back in like after like. You want to dress? Want to do something fun? What's an SCP that interests you? Actually, what's a Project Moon abnormality that interests you?
Do we ask? I'm not entirely sure myself. Just several.
Okay. You know what we're going to do?
Eh?
Because most of the original 1,000 will show up in Container Breach.
Mm.
Because this was made back during the original 1,000.
Mm. I am tooth.
So let's see. We have the living room, biological motherboard, 12 rusty keys, blah, 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 blah. Zombie plague. Zombie plague does show up. Different from 049.
I'm curious about the Brewing Heaven one.
The Brewing Heaven?
Blowing.
Well, that would be Peanut.
No, I'm talking... Wait.
Brewing Heaven is the Lobotomy Court monster.
Then,
There's the Vermin God. Hold on. Sentient Civil War... Okay. This is the first 1,000, which is most relevant to this game, because most of them show up. And yes, the zombie plague does show up, and in lore, the zombie plague does breach. Basically, the apocalypse... One guy from the future of the SCP Foundation comes back and is like, yeah, the apocalypse happens. We stop most of it.
I'm curious about the whole... The sisters.
Traveling Train is the guy who goes back and is like, yeah, I know how to kill most SCPs now. Kane. We're just pointing him out. Eric's toy, if you want to look at Eric.
Yeah. I'm thinking like the King of Greed, the Queen of Hatred. The Queen of...
We don't know what SCPs they're directly referenced to, but the World War II era molecular fusion cannon. That's not the one we're thinking of, but what? The World War II molecular fucking fusion cannon.
Also, I'm curious about the notes from a crazed researcher.
It's definitely in there. But there was one we thought you would care about. The World's Breath... The World's Breath Toothbrush. TOTHBRUSH. SCP-603. The World's Best Toothbrush.
What?
We sent you the SCP stuff, and chat, we're going to leave you with this one.
Something different.
What?
It said YouTube dot... Oh,
God damn it, hold on. Might have not copied it right. Oh, yeah, it sure did fuck up. There you go. So, SCP-603, anyway, Tris, just look at whatever one you think is fascinating, but we're going to leave it on the Rot Skull. Hold on, just to make sure. Is this the guy we think it is? That's not. Tris, which one, tell us which one you're fascinated by, and we'll leave it on that one real quick while we heat up the rest of our food for like the last 2 or 3 minutes. But look at all of them. There's Eric's toy, the artist's pen. Eric's toy is the one we've seen. The one, Eric. 602 is the computer. Japanese. Which one tickles your fancy for the first 1,000? First 100, even. Shy guy.
Second chance.
Second chance? What's that SCP name?
069.
You're a horrible person, but alright.
What? I'm curious.
Yeah, but you chose 069. Yeah, alright. Anyway, hold on.
No. It's a real thing.
Oh, we know. We've looked at it. Hold on, we're just double checking. Is it the one that changes gender? No, that's a different one. Wait. Could be. Anyway, Tress, go ahead and read through it. Give your thoughts on it while we go through. When we said read it, we meant out loud.
I'm eating as well.
Okay. You know what you could do?
Eh?
Read through this because it's like several paragraphs and let your food cool. And then when we get back, eat during that. And then when we're eating, you know, I don't know, it's a fucking whole like system that could be happening. The point is, read this. Read it out loud. Once you eat that fucking food, it shouldn't take you more than 5. Do you genuinely think this is going to take you more than 3 minutes? I mean, considering Heathcliff's thing might come in 10 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
And you'll get all the time in the world to eat? Point is, read this shit out. Read it out. Tell it to the people.
Have save.
Okay, special containment procedures. That, if you can scan over it and see if you care. But description after that, it's like, that's when it gets fancy. But the containment procedures, like, that's how we contain it. Which may give you some hints. But after that, like, description's like, come on, that's cool shit. Reports of one John M. Blank, A. Blank, city firefighter who miraculously emerged from a 3-alarm building fire in which 2 firefighters, 11 civilians perished. What's up with him? I don't know. Read it. Read all that. If you want to skip containment procedures, because that's how we contain the dude, description, past all that.
SCP-069 is a presumed humanoid entity of a variable appearance and gender. Through an unknown ability, whether SCP-069 is left alone with the recently deceased human body, the body would disappear and the SCP would take on the appearance, mannerisms, and knowledge of the recently dead individual. Through extensive experimentation, it has been shown that SCP-069 is completely indistinguishable from the individual impersonates, matching with the original individual's fingerprints, DNA, and blah 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 blah. With nearly perfect precision, SCP-069 retains no knowledge of the abilities of or formal impersonations.
SV069 responds normally to injury and pain, but if cured, it'll rapidly decay into dust regardless of any preservation attempts. SV069 will then reemerge at the site of the most recent human death. There is no known maximum range to this effect, and so far has been observed to jump up to 675 kilometers. SV069 can impersonate a single individual indefinitely, however, you may negate an overriding urge to get their life in order, including but not limited to resolving outstanding financial or personal obligations, visiting extended family, updating the will and testament, and other acts or other acts of closure. When questioned, 069 professes no driving motion other than a desire to strengthen out the lives in the event of an unforeseen injury or death. 069 came to attention on Blur, 099 Blur, following the reports of one John Blur's firefighter who miraculously emerged alive from a 3-alarm building fire, which two of the firefighters and 11 civilians perished. Undercover agents attached to the local authorities were an overguide of a possible SCP when reports emerged that firefighter's equipment has been damaged beyond recognition, and has been deemed nearly impossible for the firefighter to emerge unscathed. Approximately 3 weeks later, then presumed John responded to another large-scale building fire during which he had entered a smoke-filled room alone, and it was never found. A single citizen was rescued from the building, again nearly unharmed despite the heavy smoke reported in the building. 069 was designated for the following day, and ended in the Foundation custody by members of Mobile Task Force XIE-3 Body Snatchers. Addendum 069-01, on board the 200 agent, a guard on duty assigned to SCP-069 was killed during the containment breach of SCP, and subsequently impersonated by SPC-069. Although initially in denial after being informed of an identity, it had been mostly cooperative since the impersonation of a mid-level Foundation employee. Contingencies for the use of deceased Foundation employees for the future SCP-069 is under consideration. Addendum 069-02. On 2000, SCP-069 attempted to commit suicide after a junior researcher accidentally informed that the family of Agent has been told that Agent was dead, and the subsequent reactions to the massive cost of possibly having to re-contain SCP-069, strict suicide watch measures have to be implemented. Plans to use other deceased found members are possible infestation for other SCP-069. A possible information of targets for SCP-069 has been suspended.
That's
fascinating. That's really fascinating. The idea of having that second chance, even though it's not you.
So, hold on. We think we know which one we're talking about. We just came back. Which one?
The SCP-069.
Ooh, second chance.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 humanoid entity, blah, blah, blah. That's not the one with... Hold on. Who's side of you?
It seems to have mimics the person of all things.
So it's not...
I get mimics, but they're trying to give them that redemption.
That's not who we thought it was. Okay, so if you want a second chance, Tress, can't remember which one it is, but in this we see the aftermath of it. Dr. Bright is literally contained in a... Also, did the thing come up yet?
Yeah.
for the Limbus Company? Did Limbus Company come up?
Hmm.
Well, that's what we were asking, but there is an
I don't think so.
So there is an SCP where one doctor is wearing a necklace that's an SCP. Like, there's this whole suicide cult around it.
Yeah.
And, like, the guy who kills himself, nothing happens. But then Dr. Bright, during this containment breach, this one, you can find the aftermath of it. They live. Because they weren't trying to kill themselves. They just died naturally.
Huh.
And thus, now they live eternally in the amulet and can take over people's bodies. No idea where we're going, by the way. Welcome to SCP. AK, it's all the same goddamn hallway. Welcome to Lobotomy Corp. Back at the start of the game, phenomenal. How do we cons command? How do we? Okay, and we're back at the infinite hallway.
Yep.
Because Lord knows it can just be everywhere. This way. We want to see that one hallway that had several SCPs in. This way. So we may have it. I heard a bad noise. Alright.
I already know the Shy Guy, at least.
We're not getting to him.
What do you mean, the Atomic Adventures of Ronnie Reagan?
Yep. Oh yeah, we don't remember what that one does, but yep, that's one. Okay, stop that.
Well, time to eat it.
That's what you think.
SCP-005, which is the one I'm reading into, appears to be a set of three moderately aged black and white comic books printed in 1932. The front and rear covers are missing and several pages have been rendered illegible due to water damage. We found them aged in a small antique shop in Denver, Colorado, and purchased for a small fee without incident. The owner of the shop has apparently not read the item past the publisher's date on the first page.
Of
9-5 has been revealed, but 9-5 has been revealed to be a genuine, though completely unremarkable, save for its content. It is printed on cheap old paper and inked with a dire comment on the publications of its ever.
Stop making stuff. So Tress, go ahead and see if Limbus Company's up.
I'm reading my SCP page!
We know, but while you're doing that, because it's 10 he's here.
The publisher's name indicates that it was produced by Future Funnies, a company operating out of the town of Purple Lake, Ohio.
You know what? Fuck. We can't see anything anyway.
All research inquiries thus far have shown both the company and the town can be completely non-existent. The comic itself is a pulp science fiction story entitled "The Atomic Adventures of Ronnie Reagan."
Trust me, you promised someone thick fucking blonde women. I'll tell you this:
featuring a lead character.
an unmistakable semblance to the former United States President Ronald Reagan. Each story begins with a large panel reading, in the far-fetched future world of the 1980s. Only Martin E. Reagan can save the day. It appears to follow an episodic format with one self-contained story per publication. Three stories are briefly described below. Barney vs. the Space Admiral Carter. This story pits planetary governor Ronald Reagan and a psychic space major Herbert against the titular Space Admiral Carter, as they both be in the position for Space Marshal. The events loosely follow these the events of the 1980 presidential election. Space Assassin. This story follows a character named Spaceman Hinckley as he put it.
Trust, it's all gone bad. You have no idea, it's all gone fucked.
Prepares to assassinate Space Marshal Reagan. He manages to catch Reagan by...
Trust the old man is here. I'd love to hear about the fucking rail... the old man.
Reagan has surprise wounded him with his Devastator Ray before being subsumed by Reagan's soldiers. This event is obviously referring to the 1981 assassination attempt by John Hickley Jr. Jungle Planet. The story follows Reagan's attempts to create an army of robots on the jungle-covered planet of Nika in order to protect it from the evil sand bandits. Although Reagan is told he will lose his command if he interferes with the events of planet Nika, he sends his lieutenant, Space Colonel West, to secretly build a force on the covered jungle. When the planet is covered, Space Colonel West takes the blame and saves Superior. It's the storyline of the simplified retelling of the Iran-Contra controversies in 1986. Possibly most interesting is the final page of each book, which advertises other stories published by future funnies. Indications on the way to locate any surviving copies at once, the advertising stories are listed below. Space Marshal Herbert assumes command. Starman Willing vs. Space Succubus, Globe Walker and Sneak Attack, Barry Technides on Planet Alfgar, Planet Dynie and Put Him on the Riz, Sky and Mom Sarah of the Ice World, Flying Franken vs. Rocket Rush, Star Command Proton in a Losing Battle, and The New Menace Death to Mankind. Personal Lager, blah, 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 blah. 8-10-06-04. I don't think I need to emphasize how important it is to recover any of all the advertised stories immediately, the final two in particular. And that's it.
So anyway, it's up.
What?
Yep.
Ah. Ah.
So we're gonna stop the stream and restart it again. And Trish, you're not allowed to leave because you're gonna come with us on this adventure, we assume. While doing it yourself. Listen here. You read through the entire fucking story last time while we were in a mirror dungeon. You're not allowed to leave. We're gonna stop the stream. We'll be right back.